Y'all hear that? Talk about. She said, you got an accent.
What is you saying?
Brother Al at your service, huh? Used to worry about the other side, but the other side ain't worried, huh? Used to have metric tons of pride, but the flesh had to get buried, huh? Told the truth, not a single lie, then you run a high like Murray, huh? Used to worry about the other side, but the other side ain't worried, huh? Used to have metric tons of pride, but the flesh had to get buried, huh? Told the truth, not a single lie, then you run a high like Murray. Hey, Brother Al at your service, I hope you enjoyed the music as much as I'll enjoy making it. It's, you know, I was making these records just to encourage me at first. It really wasn't about you. You know, then over time, still make them to encourage me. Still ain't about you. But I hope you're blessed by it. Nonetheless, these records are to encourage me and document time and space and everything else. And for me, to this is my joyful noise unto the Lord. That's just how I contribute it. You know. So you do what you do, and I'll make a joyful noise unto the Lord the way he has blessed me. And that's by stringing words together creatively to get the same point across. Amen. So basically preaching to you on these records, as I once said. So let's pray, and then we're going to get into the topic. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord God, I thank you, Lord God, for just being faithful to me, dear Father God, and helping me to be faithful concerning the small things, Lord God. Lord God, you know what I'm asking you for, and everybody underneath the sound of my voice, to Father God, who hears this globally, Lord God, I ask, you know what they're asking for. So we want the things that we ask you for, Lord God, but Lord God, give us the strength to do what's commanded of us so that we may receive of you, knowing we can ask of you and receive anything. In Jesus' name, amen. So, without further ado here, okay, I'm blacked out today, boy. Beer black, you know what I'm saying? Koofy black, shirt black, let's do it. Okay. Y'all, please forget that. I know that joint just went off crazy. Check me out. Blessings, right? After suffering. That's the working title we're doing right now. Blessings after suffering. We taught to focus on the blessings of the Lord, because that's one of the driving or motivating forces for you to stay safe. God, no, you wouldn't serve him if there was nothing in it for you. That's why he had this mention, like, I go to prepare a place for you. Store up your treasures in heaven. Because he knew that it has to be enough to want to keep you out of sin. Uh-oh. Has to be enough. He know you're going to always ask for things. He gave you the innate ability to love somebody who sacrifices for you. He gave you the ability to love because he first loved you. If you had no evidence that he first loved you, would you love him? No, you wouldn't. It's because of how you wired. So, blessings after suffering. Oh, man, I bought it out. I'm going to bring it out just right now. Just a little bit, though. Say, what credit is that for you? Even sinners love those sinners, right? And they do the same for each other. You know that scripture, you know. So it's trying to teach you how to have that perfect love like Christ had. But let's find out where your blessings are connected in your suffering. Let's go to Romans chapter 8. And let's go to verse 18. And it says, for I reckon that the suffering of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory that shall be revealed in us. So the suffering of this present time
is directly connected to the glory that'll be revealed in us, what, later? The suffering of this present time is nothing compared to, so X amount of suffering equals XY amount of blessings. The suffering versus the blessings be so good after you suffer and come through a thing completely and righteously and holy. The blessings be so good, you will forget that you ever suffered. Who had a blessing from the Lord that was so good it made you forget your suffering? You like, Brother Al, you ain't been through nothing. There's some suffering you go through, brother. Put a mark on your life, brother. You'll never forget. I'm not taking that away from anybody. Got my own stuff things over here. Let's do another one. Let's go to 1 Peter, right? Let's go to 1 Peter, and then let's go to chapter 3, and let's go to verse 9. Real quick, we'll touch on, I got one more scripture after this, and then I'm going to run my mouth. 1 Peter 3 and 9, not rendering evil for evil, or railing for railing, but contrarywise, blessings, knowing that ye are thereunto called, that ye should inherit a blessing. So don't you know when you don't render evil for evil, there's suffering involved in that? If you are not programmed not to do it? Don't you know making somebody reap what they sow and avoiding that? You know, you making them reap what they sow, right? When you make somebody reap what they sow, but if you avoid that and you don't render evil for evil, like you shot my cat, I'm gonna kill your dog. Well, you took my wife, I'm taking your wife and your sister and your mama. Like, what? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, so let's not render evil for evil, but look at the blessings behind it. Knowing contrarywise, what? But contrarywise, don't do that. Bless them. Why would we do that? Why would we bless them? Because you got a reward coming. So don't you know these things are on a bigger scale? Like, but don't you know right after, be looking for a blessing after you suffer. Ain't nothing wrong with that. That's what you can count on. How many of you, I mean, sometimes, don't get me wrong, I know we can go through some suffering, succotash. Like, we could go through some suffering, right? Suffering. We can go through it. But check it out. Does the suffering rob you? Have you, like, given up? Or have you suffered so long you forgot what you was asking for? So all you can look is for the bigger picture, which is just, you know, I'm suffering and heaven's next. Bless the Lord. Sometimes you suffer so long you can forget what you asked for. And the order you asked to receive it in. Ain't that terrible? That's terrible. That's some suffering right there for you. If That's for your soul. Like, oh, I suffered so long in this thing, I can't even remember what I asked God for. The suffering robbed me of my ability to remember what I wanted. Take your eyes off the suffering, but know it's directly related to the blessing. If we look at Job had his eyes on the suffering, no doubt. Right? It was his present danger. Right? It was his present thing. Job had his eyes on the suffering. Right? He had his eyes on the suffering. He couldn't turn away from it. And everybody around him made him reflect back on his suffering as if some strange thing happened to him. But look, what the blessing did. We don't spend as much time in Job's or his God-ordained crisis. We don't spend as much time on his blessings and what he received afterwards. We just don't spend as much time. You know, not enough is thoroughly written about it. It's like, okay, he got what he got. God blessed him. You know, triple, quadruple, this, that, houses and land, children, all the rest. New, you know, maybe new wife. I don't know, right? So, like, he got all of this. But that's a short story. Job may have never received another test afterwards. He may have never been tempted afterwards. God may not have to go back and touch his vessel again. So why can't we come through and suffer, cry out, come through correctly? How we know God gonna put us through again? I mean, unless something else is in you that needs to come out. Great. He making you fit for heaven. You think Job had to suffer anymore after being served up on the platter to the devil? Last scripture. Run over here to Proverbs with me. Come on now. I want to entertain some thought. I want to get your mind working. You come up with something new. Don't be afraid to shoot it in the comments or something hit your spirit. The blessings of the Lord maketh rich. Proverbs 10:22. The blessings of the Lord maketh rich, and he addeth no sorrow with it. So after one has suffered, see, all this big suffering on the big scale, on the life scale is about, I'm suffering so I can make it to heaven. What about suffering for the last thing that you asked God for? You said, well, if I'd known I'd have been suffering this much for it, I wouldn't have asked for it. Yes, you would. Because you would have had the faith to suffer because you knew what was required. So you still would have asked for it. Well, I wouldn't have went through. No, you would. If God shows you what you got to deal with to suffer for what you get, you see the expected end. That requires no faith. So you will suffer better. You're suffering. You'll be like, you've seen the end of a thing. So in your mind, you firm in your foundation. Yeah, suffering. I'm going to take it. Yeah, it's all right. It hurt, though. Yeah, I'm working with it, though. Bless the Lord. I seen the end. You seen. See, Job didn't see anything. And right now, you may not see anything. I'm talking to you, Al. Brother Al. What? This for you, sir. You may not see anything. But if you did, it would help you hold firm in your faith because you've seen it. You may not see anything. But the blessing is there. The reward is there for after you done with this. My sister, the reward is there for after you done with this. It's there. But who's to say God's got to make you suffer anymore, ever again, if you come through this thing right? It may take, this why your suffering may be taking this long. What if it's the last one? And your life on Job Easy Street, not even worth writing about after that. You in. Right? The blessings of the Lord maketh rich, and he addeth no sorrow with it. Amen. Let's look forward to the blessings of the Lord. But let's also prepare to endure. The Bible says, he that endureth to the end. So endurance requires what? Suffering. If you endure a 12-mile run on a treadmill, your body's going to endure what? Suffering. It's going to cramp up, spaz out, right? It's enduring. So we want to endure as a good soldier. Your blessings after your suffering. Sufferings after your blessings. This is my time with y'all, Brother Al, at your service.
flesh had to get buried. Other side not thinking about me, just waiting on me to get here. That's a blooming, the fish are booming, the coast is ready to live here. Judgment looming, these heathens grooming, the gray they chasing, they sent him. COVID came, thought hearts would change, they drove the lane, talking nothing's changed. Extinction came and the sin remained, the arena changed, they felt the same. Told the truth in every chain link, letter came, didn't rap the same. Hold the truth, cause death is proof that the party poops. Nothing left when the lights is off, but to hear the truth.
Man.
When the